yes, I'll be honest with you, this game is very, so I was actually, I was watching another person play this game as a background noise. I didn't really pay much attention to it, and there was just some dialogue that I kind of caught on. I was like, wow, this is, like, really fucked up. Let's, maybe I should play it. I know we're, like, these characters, they're siblings, they're locked up in an apartment with, apparently, with some kind of parasitic infection, and they can't get out of their room. Like, the whole building's under quarantine, I think, they're starving. So let's see how that plays out. Anyways, let's go. Episode 1, The Coffin. Leyley, I don't want to. Well, I do. Just go over and to the you. I thought she's your friend. Mom said you'd help me with anything. We'll get in trouble. Oh. Good morning, Ashley. As much as you love feeling sorry for yourself, it is time for a little interlude. It is titled, Find Nutrients to Not Die. Ready, set, go! Yeah, this place looks awful. A bunch of rented movies. Their due date passed ages ago, but what can you do? Mother won't pick up no matter how many times you call. We also try to order food a bazillion times, but for whatever reason, the orders never arrive. Quarantine was a word I was looking for, that's what it was. The freezer's completely empty. This is where you and your older brother pile your trash. It's already been scavenged several times, and it's truly and utterly exhausted as a food source. But wait! What's that? Got a can of tomatoes. Amazing. You should show that to your brother. A lone trash bag. Nothing worth mentioning is inside. The front door won't budge. We've been locked in here for months now. I don't like the music. The game. Oh! Whatever. Just leave it. Okay. I'm gonna take the glasses off. It's bugging me. Your parents have fucked on this... Okay. God. Junk and unpaid bills, they cannot be eaten. You're used to filling your stomach with water, but it's not enough. Your body demands sustenance. I said show the tomato can to your brother. God damn it, don't be so greedy all the time. Jesus, I'm sorry. The coffee machine sits alone, sad, and abandoned. There are only so many times you can brew the same ground, so no more coffee in this house. Ugh. Oh my god, it's white noise, how thrilling. Who wouldn't want to be stuck at home when you've got an entertainment like this? DHS player cannot be eaten. This way. It's a washing machine. A mop. Detergent. Drinking this gets more and more tempting every day. Oh my god. What kind of shower is this? It's a cleaning closet. Inside are various supplies, such as trash bags. Her dialogue doesn't change. Wait. Light switch. Nope. Balcony door is locked. I'm guessing our brother's this way. Yep. I love the way we walk. It's kind of funny. Dirty laundry. In the trash lay your hopes and dreams. exactly where they belong. Jesus. There's an old drawing in the drawer. Andy and Leyley and the very, very... And this very, very something quiet. Oh, it says Andy and Leyley in the very, very quiet in all capital letters. No, sorry, it's Andy and Leyley in the very, very quiet, as your original vision clearly intended it. Your artistic abilities have not increased since. An alarm clock is ticking away. A hoodie. Alright. You show him the tomato can. Ta-da! Ugh. Not the reaction you were hoping for. Ta-da! We're not eating that. Huh? No, that's the very last thing we have, Ashley. I think we should hold on to it a little longer. Quit your complaining. You're energetic enough to go rummaging through our trash, so clearly you're not dying yet. Huh? How'd you know it was in... Because I hid it there, away from you. I live in a den of snakes! Don't rot me up, you're making me hungry. Do you know what would help with that, Andrew, my dear? No, put the tomatoes away somewhere. Put them in my mouth, that will. I can see that your heart is set on this. Fine. Let's eat them then. Screw our future selves. Time for you to go cook some tomatoes. I'll be there in a bit. Good day, are you still alive in there? Hello, if you won't make a sound, I'll assume you're dead. And I don't bring food for the dead. You don't bring it to the living either! I'll take that as a yes, still alive. And don't blame me for the delivery guys screwing up. Did you go grab something from the store for us? Nah, not my job. I'll check in on you again later. Bye. No, wait! Wait, come back. He doesn't. God damn it. Yeah, they're not in a very good predicament. You boil the canned tomatoes to make delicious boiled canned tomatoes. There's even a little bit of pepper left to season with. This is some gourmet stuff right here. A little salt, though. You've used all of it to spike your water in order to avoid overhydrating yourself while drinking to fill your stomach. Oh my god. Well, how is it? At this point, you could feed me a can of worms and I'd say it's the best thing I ever ate. Kiss ass. No, I'm saying that's how hungry I am. It is in that moment that an ominous audio assaults your eardrums. Are you kidding me? The neighbor's at it again? Wanna go take a peek? Nope. But I'll come along if you do. Here, catch. Got balcony key. Nope. No, I can't talk to him. It's just some dirt. Oh, I can't interact with that. Oh, no other dialogue when he's tagging along with you, I guess. Unlock the balcony door. An ashtray. There are no cigarettes left to smoke, but it's still good for bashing things in. Oh my god. Can't really see squat from here. You contemplate if you should take a leap of faith towards the neighbor's balcony. It's only the fourth floor. Ashley, don't you even think about it. Ah, he's no fun. Guess you'll have to set something up to cross. I was actually not even looking at that. You can't cross this as it is. I was actually looking in the window, but okay. The hell? I don't remember seeing like a board or anything we could use. Oh, well. Just leave it for now. The mess came in handy after all. The shelf piece. Got a wooden plank. God, even this building's decrepit. Set down the wooden plank. The boxes are full of useless junk. Alright. Oh my god. Oh, demons from hell. Hear my plea. Oh, the unholy ones, I come seeking your advice. God damn it. What am I doing wrong? I thought that was perfect. I knew I should have killed that guy when I had the chance. What do you make of that? Everybody needs a hobby, I guess. Forget this. Isn't it almost time they let us watch TV? Oh my god, they manage when you watch TV? That's so fucked. Oh, that's really fucked. Really, like, truly fucked. That is terrible. The remote's dead. Just push the buttons on the TV. Ugh, what a pain. Fine, I'll fetch some batteries for you. I always have to do everything around here. Yeah, woe is you. It is. I just noticed he's got his, like, tag sticking out of his shirt. I don't know why, but that's, like, that little detail's adorable. Do you find the batteries? I guess it shows how little he cares about his parents currently, too. Batteries. Where the fuck do I find batteries? Take it out of the clock? You take the batteries out of the alarm clock. Got batteries. Oh my god, he's gonna be so pissed. Not that he needs it anyways. God, I hope you can't hear my washing machine. Thank you kindly. Now praise me. Wow, amazing. You did such a bang-up job. More. Oh, you haven't sent God's gift to humanity. How did life ever subsist in your absence? No one fetches batteries like you do. I sit in awe of your very existence. You sit in awe. You should sit too, starting. Thank you for tuning in. Today we share with you some joyous developments in regards to the tainted water situation. Oh, that's right, it was tainted water. We're happy to announce that all apartments to which the tainted water had been delivered have been secured. It has been 3 months since the first incident was discovered, and the death toll is now at a comfy 53 total. Comfy? No biggie. And the quarantine period for those who were at risk has been extended by another 2 weeks. Again? And to our friends in quarantine, thank you for keeping your disgusting, parasite-infested bodies far, far away from me. Sorry, it's thank you for your continued consideration to the public's safety. That's all for today. Cheers! I'm going to bed. You decide to do the same. Oh, what the fuck? Wait, Mom, where are you going? Me and your father will be staying in a hotel for a bit. I thought they said we should stay at home until... I didn't drink anything. Mom. Not booze, not dirty contaminated water, nothing. The only thing I've drank is some orange juice from a carton. Anyway, I'm gonna miss my bus. You and Andrew can join us later. Bitch. Alright, this won't hurt a bit. The nurse sticks a needle in you. There we go. And now you. How long do we have to stay home? The results from your blood work will be done tomorrow. If your birthday is well, you're free to come and go as you please after that. And if not, then you'll go to see what... Then you'll get to see what happens if not. That's all for now. Take care! Stop calling me, Ashley. Please. If you need something, ask the workers... If you need something, ask the workers there. I can't do anything for you. And I don't want to hear these lies about starving anymore. What, you bitch! Why the hell would I lie about this? Listen, this new apartment is a bit of a fixer-upper, so I'm really busy. Besides, isn't Andrew there with you? What do you need me to pacify you for? You get to laze around all day doing nothing. I don't know what you've got to complain about. Anyway, I've got to go. Please don't call anymore. I won't answer. Goodbye, Ashley. I'm sorry. No, the fuck you ain't. You're a terrible person! Oh my god, no wonder these children got issues. After reminiscing all night, you wake up, as one does. Instead of ruminating upon your misery, you decide to clean the house up a bit. How? I too sleep just like that. Oh god. There's ticking, but there's no clock. Oh shit. I got a new mic. I'm sorry if you hear the keyboard a little bit. I hope it's not too bothersome. I try not to, it's like, as long as I don't hit it too hard, it shouldn't be too bad. But like, I have the mic kind of set up really weird because I can't really, I don't have a good setup, so. No longer using the headphone mic because I got tired of the buzzing noise. Picked up some laundry. cleaning. What a waste of energy. That made me yawn. You're a waste of energy. Thanks. Just don't overdo it. Come to think of it, do we even have any detergent left? Andrew's too exhausted to chat. He looks tired. You're not going to get this clean with your bare hands. Are you implying it's very dirty? Hey, wait. Did I inspect that table before? No, okay. I did, but it seemed like there's nothing on there. Wait, one more. Sorry. Okay. I guess that's all the clothes. Got detergent. You'd run the laundry. Now what else could you clean? You. Yourself. Oh my god. Got a mop. Oh, floor I guess. Yeah, it is pretty dirty. Mop some dirt. What else is there to take care of? Good question. Books on the ground. That's one. Clean up some books. Return all the books to the shelf. Ugh. You're feeling dizzy. Oh! Damn it, Ashley. I told you not to overdo it. I guess when you're starving, you lack energy. Honestly. Hmm? Good news once again. Some of you may have heard from your loved ones that there's been supply shortages in the quarantine households. Well, boy, are we pleased to announce that all that has been taken care of. It has? Does it look like I'm eating right now? On that note, we'd like to remind all of you not to enter the contaminated apartments. No, your friends don't need anything from you. Everything's taken care of. Should you steal? Oh, no! Oh, well. I hope that clears things up a bit. Moving on to our next story, a brand new art museum will be... You drift back into unconsciousness. You're too tired to get the phone. Hello? Of course. What is it? The shift in the tone of his voice makes you strain your ears. No, no. Go ahead. Someone's talking on the other end of the line, but you can't make out the words. They sound more and more upset as they talk, though. Well, that's... I mean, I can't do anything about that. Or I can try talking to her, but... No, I mean, yes, but that doesn't... No, I'm not angry, I'm just... No, I... Can you let me talk? The voice on the other end must have said no. It's increasingly loud, but you still can't make out all the words. Always about... You don't... Aunt Lay and Ashley and... You've had the time to think... Just can't anymore. So that's it then? Now it's quiet on both ends. Well, alright, I guess. What else is there to say? Sorry? Although I really don't see why I should be held accountable for... A faint beep 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 of a dropped call can be heard. Who was it? My ex-girlfriend, apparently. Ooh, she dumped you? Why is that? Why do you think? How should I know? Maybe because you're a parasite-infested homebody that's apparently perma-quarantined? Or because she found someone new? It's been a few months, buddy. Or maybe she just didn't like you that much in the first place. Whatever you say, Ashley. There might have been something more tactful to say. Yeah! Whatever, you pretend to sleep until you really fall asleep again. Now you've been out for who knows how long. You figure you should check on your brother. Alright. Oh, yep, still outside, I guess. Wait, oh, yeah. Wait, what about the laundry? Yeah, fuck laundry, right? Wait, you have a washer, but where's your dryer? I guess you have to hang the clothes to dry. Oh boy. The one from your apartment is getting hauled into an ambulance. Oh, this is the conversation that caught. Wait, this is the conversation I tuned in on that led me to be like, I gotta play this game myself. It's so fucked up. I gotta play it. Hey, me too! People are yelling from their windows and balconies. I need some help too! Please, please, I'm starving! Soon the ambulance leaves in a hurry. Color me surprised, they actually got the person some help. I figured they'd just let her die. Maybe she did die. She wasn't moving. As if they'd have their sirens blaring for a corpse. Then what do you suppose was her emergency? No idea. Nobody showed up when you fainted. Well, did you call for anyone? What do you think, dumbass? No, no. Maybe she went into labor or something. Yeah, maybe. Think they'd bring me food if I got Nope. Let me finish! How would you even get pregnant in here? Well, we do have that one charming fellow right next door. Over my dead body. He seemed a little off his rocker, so who knows? He just might end you. Forget this. Well, excuse the hell out of me for exploring my options here. That woman did look pregnant anyway. Whatever, it was just a thought. Jackass. You'd like to go after Andrew and tell him it ain't none of his damn business anyways, but you're just too exhausted. But after sleeping for a few hours, or maybe a few days, who knows? You're finally fully revitalized and bursting with energy. That doesn't look like bursting with energy. Ooh. Oh, you silly lazy bones. What day is it? How long have you been locked in your apartment now? Where the hell does Andrew get the energy to make so much noise? He has unscrewed the lock and is attempting to kick the door in. Or out, depending on your perspective. How many more times are you going to try that? It's clearly barred from the other side somehow. What else am I supposed to do? If you don't stop banging on the door, I won't be bringing you any food tonight. You want it either way. Says you, the delivery will be here in a matter of hours. But I guess you don't want anything. Yeah, that's right. Now you better stop banging on the door, or next time it'll be me banging on head against the wall. The man's footsteps fade away. Do you think they'll really get that delivery today? Like, I didn't fuck this up for us, did I? Unlikely. Though I guess we'll see. And see you did. That absolute nothing was delivered. Ugh. Talk about something. I got nothing. Try. So, parasites. It's been a few months. Are you feeling anything? Hunger. You'd think something would be happening to us by now. Yeah, they'd be crawling out of your fucking body. But I haven't noticed anything. That nurse never came back either. Like, don't you want to monitor us? Who cares? Me, Ashley, I care. Well, I don't care nor care that you care. Aside from the starving, it's not so bad here. Come again? Aside from starving, I like it here. Well, I don't. I want to jump off the balcony. Ooh, I'll race you. No, seriously, let's go. Let's not, though I appreciate your eagerness to join me. But it's a bit too romantic, so I'll pass. Excuse me? What, you don't see it? Just imagine hitting the ground together, and with such force our bodies turn into a pile of gory mush, never to be separated. Our remains would get so tangled up they'd have to bury us together in the same coffin. Might as well, we've been confined together in this coffin of an apartment for what feels like an eternity already. I'm not jumping off the balcony with you. Get your head checked. I should get my head checked. No wonder your girlfriend dumped you. Those are your plans for romance. Not romance, I said romantic. They're not the same thing. Romantic just means something is... The neighbor starts blasting his favorite ritual music for all to hear. Again? I wish he'd just... Oh. You feel like you should check up on that. Okay. My lord, you've come. And you're a little smaller than I imagined. I love it. It's better than I imagined. That's all I meant. What do you offer, human? Oh, I don't have much to give right now. But if you help me get out of here, I can get you anything you wish. Is that no good? As you wish, human. My lord, thank you, thank you. Perish. Darkness clouds your vision, and you cannot see what's happening. By the time your vision returns, the entity has vanished. On the ground lay the lifeless body of the cultist. So, am I already delirious, or did you see that too? Do we want to check on him? Well, at the very least, I want to turn on his CD player. That's what you're concerned about? I am not listening to this for the rest of my life, Andrew. You make it sound like we're going to die any day now. Well, aren't we? Well, I'm not. There's got to be something this guy has that we can eat. Burglary time. Shut up, and let's get in there. The doorknob talks to you from the other side of the glass. Okay, so, I don't know what happens after this part. This is where I stopped watching. Got an ashtray. Oh, are we gonna smash it with this? Door or not? Man, what do you do with this mattress? Closet is big enough to hide in. Are you trying to tell me something, game? On the table sits a book titled Demon Summoning for Dummies, Volume 666. Now, did they actually have 665 volumes for this one, or... She asks the important questions, but what I want to know is, who the hell wrote it in the first place? Undisclosed, the author must be shy. Well, either way, we can browse this later. Let's keep our focus on the task at hand. That's a lot of meat, you think to yourself. What? Out loud, apparently. Though, I mean, is it still illegal if we didn't kill this guy? Is what illegal? Well, you know. Oh, you want to eat him! Is that what you were insinuating? No, I was just making an observation. Oh, but we can't. If we do eat him, then that's it for us. There's no way we wouldn't get caught once they finally let us out. But it's not like we killed the guy. I think just messing with the corpse is a crime, too. Well, I think they should just look past it, given that there's nothing else to eat. Will the staff here admit that they didn't give us food, though? And before that, you're going to tell them a demon killed him? Really? That'll fly. Listen, you're overthinking the hell out of this. Are we doing this or not? Andrew, I'm expecting an answer. Yeah. All right, then. Let's find something to butcher him with. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. What the fucking fuck? Okay. We're totally doing this. We're totally doing this, and she's totally fine with it. The candle is burnt out. Oh, my God. Both the fridge and freezer are empty. Got a cleaver. Oh, my God. It's just as locked as your door. I'm gonna check his place out before I cut him up. While looting the jacket's pockets, you find a wallet with $666.66 inside. Now you've got a real moral dilemma here. Stealing a dead man's wallet. Will you split with Andrew? Aw, aren't you a sweetheart? You got $33.33. I'll use some of mine to treat you something someday, maybe. Huh. Did that do something? The bathroom smells feces, and you feel zero inclination to investigate further. Oh my God. Okay. Oh God, okay. So, you get the arms. I'll handle the legs. First you chop- Oh my God, okay. This is terrible. We're terrible people. First, you chop off the cultist's left arm. Next up is right arm. Oh my God. We can't carry him out in the open like this. Just be quick about it. No, can't you go get some plastic bags or something? I'll take care of the rest in the meanwhile, I guess. I'm counting on you, Andy. Don't call me that. You hand him the cleaver. Go get it done, all right? Just go get the bags. Or what? Did you want to watch? Say watch. I'll watch, thank you very much. Why? Don't you trust me? Boy, are you being a little bitch today. Just let me watch, all right? Okay, then. Andrew readies himself, clearly averse to doing what he is about to do. Ugh, fuck me. Oh my god, what are we doing? Go, Andy, go! Go, Andy, go! Shut the fuck up, you basket case! All right, the warden might hear. Well, that and... whatever. Better hurry up, son. It's just meat. It's just some meat. Are you drooling? I'm hungry, all right? You're gross. Go get those plastic bags already. Leave it to me. They're like multiple endings. You need to conceal this before taking it with you. Oh, God. Well, yes, these are perfectly suitable plastic bags. They're also full already. You'd rather not carry the meat you're about to eat inside a used trash bag. Find something else. Yeah, that's true. God, this is fucking terrible. There's plastic bags in here, right? Yeah. This is episode one, too, so there's like, so that means there's going to be more, right? Like, how are you gonna add, like, what more can you add to this? Like, I'm actually really curious. I don't think I want to know. Okay, hold on. Got left leg. Oh my god. Right leg. Right arm. Left arm. Oh wait, is there a room this way? No. A small problem presents itself. The plastic bags aren't big enough to fit the whole torso in them. Crap. I don't think we can cut through the spine, either. Just fold him over? I don't think that's going to work. Watch and learn. Yeah, see, if anyone happens to be looking out their window, it'll be a disaster. Maybe if I use two bags? Listen, this isn't going to... Ta-da! Good God, no, don't make me laugh at this. I don't have the power to make you do anything, Andrew. Alright, enough. Gather the limbs up and go. There should be plenty enough room for them in our freezer. I'll stuff the torso and head in his freezer for now. Then I'll go cook us something while you're at it. Yeah, you'll cook quite the something. God. Take the limbs to our freezer before they start decaying. Andrew said he'd deal with this. Oh my god, this is so fucking terrible. Oh my god, this is awful. That's our freezer. You place the severed limbs in the freezer. Now which one do you want to eat? Oh my god. It gives me the option. La, 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 right arm. Alright, time to cook. Oh my god. You fry some meat. Dinner's ready. Oh my god. Right, so what are we having here? Pure deliciousness is what? Eat up! You first. Mm-hmm. What? Oh, you already... Okay. Eat, Andrew. You will not waste this. Right. Andrew takes a bite out of your cooking. I don't think he likes it. He begins retching. No, you don't! Swallow. All of it. Well, how is it? It's... God, I hate picky eaters. I made this with love! You're not leaving the table before you've licked the plate clean. Quit your nagging, woman. Then quit your nagging, you big baby! I'll eat it, alright? Just give me a minute. Under your watchful eye, he slowly finishes his plate. What, are they eating it fucking raw? Oh my god. Good boy, I'm so proud. Just fuck off, Ashley. What an odd way to say thank you. Yeah, thanks a bunch. I'll clear the table, so leave me alone. We've got a very limited set of spices left, but what do you think I should try next? I don't know, maybe coriander? Alright, I'll try that tomorrow then. I'm off to bed now. Night-night. Yeah, good night. Hey, Ashley. If we ever get out of here, you really should go get your head checked. Huh? Just a thought. Sweet dreams. Can I go down? I can. God. Oh my god. Inside the freezer, the cultist's torso. The head is in the fridge for some reason. This freezer ran out of space. God. I don't think there's anything else we can do in there. Alright, bed we go then. Off to bed we go! I think. Yeah. You fall asleep, fully content with your life decisions. Oh my god, I would not rest peacefully after that. At all. Said she likes you. Who? My friend from school? Or at least I thought she was a friend. So are you going to be her boyfriend? Gross, no. I can teach her a lesson. You're my brother. Mine. I'll make her think twice before stealing from another woman. Oh yeah, you're a girl too. What's that supposed to mean? Somehow you don't count as a lady in my mind. Or as a person for that matter. Screw you! I'm the most personest lady in the world. So anyway, I'm gonna take her to that old warehouse and lock her in one of the crates. Oh my god, you were a psychopath even as a kid! Yeah, yeah. Seriously! Mom gave me some money to go buy groceries. Are you coming with? Focus, Andy. Let's leave her sitting there all night. That'll show her. Let's not. You should go ask her to hang out. She won't say no then. Leyley, I don't want to. Just go over and ask her to come with you. Take her to the warehouse and we'll see what happens. Come on. Mom said you'd help me with anything. I thought she's your friend. Well, I thought so too. And she can be my friend again afterwards. She just needs a reminder how to do it proper. We'll get in trouble. I'll only let her out when she promises not to tell on us. Do it, Andy. I guess. Hooray, you're the best! Today's episode is titled Andy and Leyley and the Bitch in a Box. One day you'll be a bitch in a box and your friends will take turns pissing on the ground above. What do I do about these hussies around you? Where do you learn these words? The bitch is you. I'll take you out to play, and when I'm done, it's back into the box with you. I really ought to kick your ass one of these days. Oh my god, I think she has a very bad... What's taking him? He wouldn't have forgotten her plans, would he? Finally. What are you doing here? Surprise! I want to hang out too. Oh. I mean, I guess that's fine. Say, did you tell your mom you're here? No, why? Just wondering. I mean, I'm surprised she let you come hang out with a boy. No way, she thinks I went to study with Julia. But why are you here, Ashley? Divine intervention. What's that even mean? It means she's full of crap. Don't listen. So, are we going inside or what? Is that allowed? I allow it. Let's find a way in right now. Oh my god, she's a horrible person! She's a horrible person! And Andy is a little fucking pushover. Why'd they nail this metal sheet thing on the wall? Looks like there's a hole behind it. Perfect. Tear it open. What? I can't do that. It's okay. I won't tell anyone. As in, I literally can't do it, dumbass. Not without some tools, at least. Even though it's this flimsy? Yes. I like smart guys over beefy ones. Who asked? Steel mallet. I can't really think of a way a mallet would be useful in this situation. I sure can. As in, help us get in the warehouse? Okay, yeah. In that case, no. Leyley, I don't even want to know what you had in mind. What are you guys talking about? It's nothing. Let's keep looking. Got hammer. Oh my god, this is gonna be horrible. Wait, why? The drop off on the other side of the window is too high. I wouldn't mind convincing to jump anyway. To maybe twist her ankles. Maybe break her neck. Is something wrong? Nah, but we can't go in this way. Oh my god, she's fucking psycho. You use the back of the hammer to pull out the nails. Wow, it sure is kind of dusty in here. Makes me wonder about my asthma. It's fine, it's fine. Ooh, I know, how about some hide and seek? You're such a kid. Huh? Andy wants to play too. You do? What? Oh, yeah, sure. See? Well, I mean, it's fun every once in a while. You totally wanted to play too, you child. Now, I'll be in. I'm gonna count to 10. She's gonna die, isn't she? Since she has asthma, she's gonna fucking die. 100! Count to 100 at least. Okay, okay. 1, 2. Alright, let's find a good box to shove her in. You still want to do that? Of course, she said no one knows she's here. This is perfect. Leyley. You promised! Now hurry up before she's done counting. God. Ooh, now this will do. There isn't even a lock on it, though. We don't actually want to lock her in. The hell we don't! There's a stick or something between the rings. That'll keep it closed. Won't the stick just break? No, well, if she's hunched inside, I doubt she'd have the leverage to. Ready or not, here I come! Aw, oh, crap, she counts too fast. It wasn't that fast, really. Let's hide, hide. Hide where? We're terrible people. Specifically, Ashley. Where do we get a stick, anyway? Andy picks up whatever wooden debris is at his feet. I guess this'll do. Well, what do you think? Is she pretty? The stick? No! What do you think, dumbass? She's fine, I guess. Found you! Both of you! Who hides in the same spot, idiots? It was my spot first. Then you're it. No way, Andy stole my spot, so he is it. Yes, yes, I'll go count. Andy goes to count outside. My hiding spots are the best. I know a really good one for you. Come take a look. Okay. God. Think you'll fit in here? It seems like a bad idea. How so? I'm gonna get my clothes dirty. Oh, boo-hoo. Who cares? My mom does. She'll get mad if I... 100. Oh, shoot, he's coming. Hurry, hurry. Okay. Hastily, your friend hops inside the crate. What was that? I got you now. It's too weak to throw you off the lid. This isn't funny, Ashley. Let me out. There you are, Andy, you slowpoke. Hurry up, she's putting up a fight. Can't breathe. She all right? Please, I... Shut up already, you drama queen. Let her out, Leyley. She's just pretending. No one's ever died from some dust. Come on, just let her out. What? You'll believe her over me? It's not really about whether I believe her or not. Fine, you let her out then. Who cares about me anyway? Everyone likes her better. I bet you like her better too. But everybody does. I already know. Oh... I bet you'd rather have a girlfriend than spend time with me. Of course you would. Well, come on. I already told you I don't want... And bet you only hang out with me because Mom told you to. Well, that's... I mean, maybe she did, but... This is not fair. Why does everyone like her better? I'm loud and weird and annoying, and no one likes me at all. I like you better, Leyley. Prove it, liar. I knew it. Maybe you'd have more friends if you weren't always so... Not even my own brother picks me over her. I knew it already. Did I not just say... La 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 la, talk sure is cheap. God damn it. There, are you happy now? Yes. Just until morning, okay? Yes, yes, you're the best. I like you the best, Andy. You hear that? You can stay there until morning. No, please. Ashley, let me out, please. Ashley, wait, don't. Go. Ashley, please. Ashley. Ashley, are you awake? I am now. Okay. What is it? Nothing, it's just... God, what the fuck did we do? You're still on about dinner? Fine, just starve then. More for me. How are you like this? How are you out of your mind? Listen, I didn't kill the guy, so I didn't do anything wrong. You mutilated and ate a corpse. What else were we supposed to do? Call the warden and let him know he died? Sir, he summoned a demon, then died. I swear we didn't do it. We wouldn't have had to admit we were there. We could have just told him to go check on the guy. Andrew, what the hell? What? What the hell? Didn't we both agree on this? I could have sworn it was your suggestion in the first place. I was too hungry to think straight, okay? Now that's bullshit. But fine, let's assume it was so. What do you want me to do about it? Whoosh, whoosh, there goes my magic wand. There. I've absolved you of your sins. You never took a bite now. You're welcome. Well, gee, thanks. We'll see how that holds in the face of the law. Listen, who cares? Ugh. Isn't this like some extreme circumstances stuff? Like, can we be excused? It's the water company's fault. First they lock us in for months, and then they won't even feed us. And is cabin fever a real thing? Maybe we can plead insanity. I don't know, Ashley. Ugh. There. You know, I couldn't get his head off. Huh? Like he didn't fit in the freezer proper. So I needed to chop his head off, but I couldn't cut it. His spine was too... Anyway, I just kinda... like kept cutting around and pulled it off. Like some... plant, I don't know. I keep thinking about it. I can't fucking sleep, Ashley, it's... Come here. I don't know what's wrong with you. How are you so unbothered? I don't know. I'm compartmentalized. Kinda like we compartmentalized that guy into a different freezer. Ashley! Andrew, what is it, Andrew? Andrew. Oh my god. Andy. Ah! I told you to stop calling me that. We're not kids anymore. Then why are you crying like such a baby? I'm not crying. Wait, mommy, the big bad me did the evil thing. You shut your whore mouth. Make me, you little bitch. Forget this. Hey, Andy, remember when we used to go on adventures? What? Andy's and Leyley's quest for something or another, remember? Why bring this up? Isn't this just another one of those? I don't know. Can you just play along for now? Until we're out of this crappy situation, then we can unpack it all together. Or not. I don't think I will, personally. But you can go to therapy. Like I could tell a therapist what I've been up to. Alright, just a thought. Let's just get out of here. Like we should've done months ago. Now that we've got food, don't you want to keep waiting until they let us out? Hell no, I don't. They'd throw us in jail right after. And I don't know which is worse. Withering in this coffin of a house or getting railed in prison. Okay. Oh, so you want to escape not only in this quarantine, but the consequences of our actions as well. Preferably, yeah. This episode is titled Andy and Leyley and the Escape from the Coffin. Yeah, whatever. I'm going to sleep now. Good night. Sleep tight. I'll try. Good night. I love you, Andy. Shove that Andy junk up your ass already. My god, I don't love you that much. You make me want to kill myself. Too bad, diving down the balcony is just too romantic for you. He'll hit you in the face so hard you see stars. Your body has absorbed some delicious nutrients and you're feeling mighty better today. Oh god, this girl. What? There's a note. There's a note stuck to the door. It reads, "Awaiting thy arrival back at the cultist's lair, Andy. Oh, I knew he'd come around. Though for a moment there, I honestly thought this was going to be a suicide note. Well, no matter. Let's see what he's up to. Oh god, I'm scared. Wait. Oh my god. Mm-mm. Hey there. Good morning. What you up to? I'm looking at this demon summoning instruction manual book thing. Great, given things turned out so well for that cultist guy. Debatable, I mean, he was successful up to the point he lacked an offering. Anyway, it says here that demons don't think much of humans. Well, that's good. We'll have something in common then. Yeah. So, they're only willing to do business as long as it's quick and easy for them. I take it you want to ask one to get us out of here? Well, I wouldn't want to get out of here the same way the cultists did. But I do think this is our best bet for now. So what will we ask from it? I don't know yet. Okay, then what will we bargain with? I don't know that either. Nice. I just barely woke up. Give me a minute. It says here demons prefer human souls, so obviously it's gotta be that. Where to get a soul while stuck in here? What are you looking at? Oh, nothing. Ashley. What? I wouldn't. Thought about it, I see. Let me keep my thoughts my own. Don't we already share enough? On second thought, let's not do this. Oh, come on. I'm not going to sacrifice you. We'll figure something out. Let's just set the ritual up for now. What's it need? I'm not done reading this yet, but you can start by replacing the candles for now. Two candles. Okay. Done. What now? Now we... Still alive and kicking, are you? You've been quiet lately, pal. I'm getting a little worried there. Yeah, hi, hello. One of my guys isn't answering. The weirdo one. I think he croaked, but he's just a B-type anyway. B-type? Is he talking about blood? Fine, I'll check it after my round. The warden's footsteps move away from the door. Is that all we would have had to get to the door open? Just shut up for 2 days? Oh shit, he's gonna come in and see all this. No. Enough. Go stall him at our door. I'll clean this up. He's still gonna find the guy missing. Unless he checks the freezer, which is where all this blood is pointing at. No. Go, before he notices we're not home. And keep him until I've mopped up all the blood. Maybe then he'll assume the guy jumped off the balcony or something. There should be a corpse below then. You get to be that corpse if you don't get going already! What are you going to do? Lick it clean? Get the mop, you dumb bastard! Damn! You dumb bastard. Honestly, that's how I talk to... That's how I talk sometimes. That's pretty realistic. What's he say? No, listen. It'll be a trade. I told you I'm not interested. I've got some good books in here. I'm sure you'd like to read them while you jack off. I thought you said it's fine literature. Oh, yeah, it's real fine. Holy cow. You'll have to see for yourself. I'll trade one book for a pack of noodles. We'll exchange them via the mail slot. But maybe it's a genre I don't like. Read me a sample. Like, did you want me to get in character too? I don't want to go into this blind. Who knows what kind of crap you're reading? It's just one pack of noodles. Don't be such a coward. Actually, I think each book is worth one of those multi-packs at least. Why is it you're always such a problem? One book for one pack of noodles. One 10-pack. Push them in one by one, then you'll get the book. Listen here, I'm the one holding off the cards here, so I decide what the pointless negotiations go on and on. That's really funny. The dude's like, he's gonna give him food for porn. Oh my god. It's honestly funny. I wouldn't think Andrew's the type to do that, but hey. Oh. Look, I I know damn well blood is not that easy to clean with just a mop. Ashley, the warden is coming. You hide in the closet successfully. Greetings and salutations. Huh? Anybody home? Oh, I should have moved that plank. Oh, great. Another suicide. What the? How did you get in here? Oh! Andrew doesn't seem too pleased with you right now. You wonder if it's a good time to tell him none of this is your fault. Come on then, Leyley, let's go play. Sheesh, I thought I got caught there. You did. Happens to the best of us. Oops. The warden is very dead. Well, you've done it now, Andy. You've actually killed a man. Like, directly. Yep. I was a little surprised there. So where's your mental breakdown? I'm saving it for later. Lay off. Yeah, well, we'll see how you sleep after this one, huh? Ashley, I am not in the mood for your shit right now. Alright. Oh, looky here. Got key to room 405. No. No. At last, you unlock the door and... Before we go, Ashley... I just want to make sure we're on the same page about something. Whatever excuse we had for eating that other guy just went out the window because you're a screw-up. Oh, I'm sorry. Did I ask you to kill him? What do you think was going to happen if I hadn't? Look, I'm not saying I'm not grateful, Andrew. I am. But what's your point? My point is that no matter what happens beyond this door, you won't speak a word of what went down here to anyone. Yeah, obviously. Obviously. And it'll no doubt be obvious we did something once this guy's shift ends and the next warden comes looking around. It's best we disappear while we can. Well, you might have noticed I'm trying. Yeah, see, I'm not sure you're grasping the gravity of our situation here. Knowing you, you think you're going to find Mom and Dad. But I'm saying all that is off the table. I hadn't planned on anything yet, actually. That's even worse. Hey, so you want me to never contact anyone I know ever again? Because you think they'll snitch on us to the authorities? Is that it? Yes, exactly. Yeah, fine, whatever. If you're going to be this flippant about this, it isn't the authorities you need to worry about. What's that supposed to mean? Are you threatening me? I am not going to jail just because you think of yourself as impervious to consequences. So you're going to take this to your grave, even if I have to put you in there myself. You don't scare me, Andrew. Don't give me a reason to. Andy, it snows in hell the day I'm afraid of you. Now back the fuck off. Who do you think you're talking to? I'm stressed out, Leyley. Yeah, I can see that. I need to know you're taking this seriously. There's half a dead guy in our freezer with my fingerprints all over it. Trust me, I'm in no hurry to tell the world about it. All good? Can we go now? Yeah, I guess. Okay, finally. Though, Andy? What? I don't give a rat's ass about Mom or Dad, or any of my so-called friends anymore. Not one of them felt it necessary to even answer my calls, or come fling food up to our balcony. Would be quite the feat to throw something so high. The point is, no one even came to try. So my affections officially died with all the brain cells I lost while starving. Ha! Which is alright, because Andy is here with me. Even though he feels like threatening me for some reason. Sorry. I guess I lost some brain cells too. Can't lose what you don't have! Oh, fuck you. Alright, let's get the hell out of here already. 401's open. Fuck off, this is a doormat. Oh my god. What the fuck? Why is got key to room 302? Is this the warden's room? Guessing so. Looky, they've got a little surveillance camera. Oh crap, are we on it? No, it looks like it's recording the second floor. Let me see. Great, there's another warden there. Is that a gun holster? The warden we kill have one? Let's go shoot this guy. Nope, he only had a key to the cultist room and a walkie-talkie. Think there's a warden on every floor? Probably. Nah, they probably work in pairs, too. It's not like they have to do anything else than keep curious people away. And pretend to feed us, I guess. Well, even though, how are we getting around them? Don't ask me! There's a key here. Fourth floor key. I completely forgot I could save in this game. Oh well. I'll just replay and see if there's another endings. Various documents detailing the selling and acquire of organs. Wait a minute. What? Hold on! I sincerely don't care. Let's just get out of here, please. I'm working on it, goddammit. It's a toilet. There's nothing of interest inside. I care. I want to read it, Andrew. Half-eaten cup of noodles. Are they harvesting us for organs? And blood? Because he said that guy was a B-type. Like he's not even important. None of the fridge reads. Notice, from now on, A-B-types won't be given supplies, except if it's someone important. And no, the lady from 302 being hot doesn't count as important. Stop asking. So is that why they're starving us too? Because they're A-B blood types? What? This is fucked up. Why are they harvesting us? I'm pretty sure that's the thing actually. Why are they? What? Okay. I want to check the other floors. Or doors. No, the door reads 2A, 1B. Where the fuck that means. Wait a minute. Hold on. That's blood types, aren't they? It's gotta be. Wait, what's on here? This is all it took to keep us in? A wooden board? It's okay, Andy. I don't have much muscle either. Your eyes say you're trying to comfort me, but your words do the opposite. And whatever. What's this slip of paper say? The paper slipped on the door reads 2AB. What's that supposed to mean? Don't know. Don't care. Yeah, let's just focus on getting out of here. Unblock the door. They are... It is blood types. What the fuck? Note on the door reads 1 O-type, but it's crossed over. They must have got them. I wonder... Yeah, they must have got them. Bro, this is so fucked up. What's this? Yeah, whatever. The elevator is out of order. Because of course it is. I was literally about to say that. Go to third floor. This looks much nicer, actually. Knowing the door reads 1A type, but it's crossed over. I wonder if that's the one that went in the ambulance. I wanted to read the note on the door, but okay. Doodles and drawings.
Hold up, don't you dare come any closer. Who are you?
Your neighbors from upstairs.
What are you doing here? Get out!
Well, we found the keys and thought you might want to get out of here. You thought wrong. Get lost!
Huh? What do you understand?
You don't want to get out of here?
That's what I said. Why would I want out? I get free food and can play games all day long. I live like a king. I hope this quarantine never ends.
Wait. They actually bring you food?
Of course. Literally anything I want. All you gotta do is ask nicely.
Like, bend over and open wide nicely?
Actually, fuck you. Get out. Both of you. Hey, didn't give me permission to go there.
Bunch of dirty dishes. I'm guessing this is a lady they were talking about was hot, fridge full of food.
You bet!
Looks like someone gave up assembling their furniture. That's probably her. I want to know what blood type she is. Well, that was something.
How come we got such different treatment? Why don't I get food?
Guess you're just not pretty enough.
You think she's pretty?
I mean, wasn't she? Whatever. Is it okay to leave her there after she saw us, though? Probably not, but you go in there swinging your cleaver and she'll definitely scream.
Then a second warden comes in and shoots us.
This is so hopeless. I think our best bet is to finish the ritual and use it to get rid of the second warden.
Well, If we can get this woman up to the cultist's room, we've got a soul to offer. How on earth are we going to convince her lazy ass to even leave her room? Beats me. Let's just finish setting up the ritual for now.
Alright.
Do you really think I'm not pretty enough? Bitch, why do you care if he thinks you're pretty?
Oh, come on.
So ugly am I that I shouldn't even be fed? Or maybe they didn't think it'd be fun to screw you while I'm loitering around the house.
Oh, yeah, okay, fair point.
And I wouldn't let them anyway.
Note the door reads 2 B-types.
I wonder what her... What does her door... I wanna know what blood type she is, damn it.
Go to 4th floor. Finish setting up the... Shitting. Finish setting up the ritual. Double check if this warden has a gun tucked away somewhere. But all you find is a walkie-talkie.
Useless.
I don't know. At least we'll hear if the other warden tries to contact this one. Which then indicates time is running out for us. Big deal. At that point, we're screwed anyways.
Hey, what if we call the warden over with this and have the demon eat his soul?
That's not a bad idea, actually.
2 birds with 1 stone. Though he'll come in guns blazing.
Yeah, right.
Let me think.
Got walkie-talkie.
Well, while you're at it, I already did a ritual for us. What do I need to do?
I don't remember. Check the guidebook.
So, what's needed to finish the ritual setup?
Draw some runes on the floor with blood. Not sure what runes, though.
I'll just redraw what that guy had already drawn. They seem to work.
Use this guy's blood? Can I not? You dip your digits in one of the warden's wounds. Why'd they write it like that? Got blood. Doing a ritual was not something I expected to do in this game. I have an idea. Excuse me.
Oh? Let's have the lady from downstairs lure the warden up here with a walkie-talkie.
And, how are we going to make her do that?
You know how. Alright then, let's go convince her.
Or was there something else that still needs to be set up? Just lighting the candles and turning on the audio. But I think it's best to do that once the warden's on his way.
Yeah, wouldn't want to keep the demon waiting.
This is so awful. We're terrible people. I don't know how to, actually. What do I do?
You two again?
Sorry.
There's one last thing we forgot to ask you. What? I thought I made myself clear. What do you want? Hey, get off me! What's going to happen now is that you'll coo into this walkie-talkie.
Huh?
Tell them that you and his friend are looking for a good time up in room 405. I don't understand. You only need to understand we'll slit your throat if you don't play nice. No, please, I'll do it. I'll tell him anything.
We'll see. You press the walkie-talkie on.
Hello? Huh? Who's there? Hi, Dave, it's me.
Where's Malcolm?
Malcolm's here with me in room 405. Did you, care for a quick visit?
A quick visit, huh?
I mean, if you want to have a good time, that is. Well, I'm always up for a good time, if you know what I mean. Was it room 405? I guess that weirdo really croaked. Nothing. I'll be right there, sweet cheeks.
You cut the conversation there.
Alright, good. Let's go.
I look over now, and what do you think she'll do?
I won't do anything, I promise.
Go finish it. I'll keep her quiet until it's done.
What? Get going, dumbass!
Fine. Oh yeah, almost forgot. Leyley.
Catch.
Andrew throws you something. Lighter. You hurry back up to finish the ritual. Turn on the audio. Oh, hold on, just in case. I supposed to do? Ah, something's here! Who are you? I can't see.
You are asking me my name, human. What do you offer?
Yikes, did I mess up? I don't want to pay for its name. I'm here! It's kind of dark, huh? And I'm not doing it with this kind of music on. Let's... Shocked, the warden reaches for his gun. Him! I offer him! What the... Ah! So, well, how is it?
Human with tar-colored soul. I give you this.
Got unidentifiable small object.
Hold it for an occasional clairvoyant dream. To gauge the troubles ahead.
Thank you. Oh, so she can see the future? The enemy has left, and you're still alive, unlike either of the wardens.
Man, that all happened way too fast.
And then I didn't get its name, nor to ask for a favor. It just did whatever it wanted. And it definitely just gave me whatever trash was lying around in its demon pockets. But no matter, the warden's dead. If I have even one clairvoyant dream, that'd be cool as hell.
You decide not to linger on the fact your soul is apparently a vicious pitch black mess.
Yeah, when a demon even tells you your soul is fucking black, that should be concerning. Guess you already knew that. Got key to second floor.
Got gun.
At last, time to shoot Andy. Just kidding. I'll probably shoot the lady, though. I'm so scared. What's gonna happen when I go back in that room? Oh my god. Third floor. I feel like Andy's gonna show his darker side. Sadly, your plans of splattering the lady's brains on the wall have been thwarted. Her corpse already rests on the bed.
What happened here?
She tried to shoot me with a nail gun. How on earth? I thought you were holding her in place! Well, I let go.
Why?
You were taking a while. I figured she wouldn't start anything as long as I had my cleaver. Lesson learned. How interesting. That you'd want to take your chances with that. For no reason. What are you getting at? You did say she was pretty. I didn't try anything with her.
Yeah. And here I was wondering why you insisted on staying behind.
Andrew shoots his load while I risk getting shot by the warden. Oh my god. Oh my god! Are you unaware that the lady's dead right now?
I guess she said no.
Screw you, Ashley. I almost got shot, too.
That's your own fault for letting her go.
God, I can't believe what a dumbass you are when it comes to women. For the last time, I wasn't trying to get with her. And even if I had, which I didn't, so what?
She's dead now.
Okay, that makes it fine then. Good to know. God, I hate it when you get like this. What's your problem?
Fucking every time.
Every time indeed. Every time some fucking floozy comes around.
Yeah, I'm not celibate. What is it to...
Yeah, I'm not celibate. What's it to you? It's always the same with you. Not true. Yeah, it is, cockbrain. Now is definitely not the time for this.
I just need you to get your priorities straight. My priority right now is getting out of here.
Your priority should be me. Blow it out of your ass. I'm not having this argument here of all places. No, shut up. Then screw the neighbor lady. And on that note, will you back the fuck off my love life, Ashley?
What's that supposed to mean?
Oh, I don't know. It's not like my girlfriend dumped me after you harassed the hell out of her or something.
What? She told you? What a tattletale. You're better off without loose-lipped whores like that.
So it really was you.
Yeah, all I did was weed out a quitter for you.
You're welcome. And I wouldn't harass anyone if you'd stop ignoring me when I need you. You always need something. You always have some bullshit crisis the moment I'm supposed to meet it with someone. I didn't mean to get up! You would. You would. I know it already.
I'm right where you want me, huh?
I'll do it then. I can just for you, you know. I have just a thing for that.
Oh my god.
Back at your beck and call, just like it was way back then. What? No, screw you, Andrew. Don't act like I'm the bad guy here.
I never once made you do anything, but it's always, I don't want to. I don't want to with you. Well, answer me this. What do you want then? Well, see, if you'd have listened to a word I said, you know I... Why don't you want to spend time with me anymore? I've done nothing but spend time with you for the past 3 months. So then why aren't we friends anymore? Of course we are. Just... forget this. Can we just go? Just what? Just go. No, answer me. What were you about to say? Stay then. I'm going. No, you don't. What's so bad about me? I've been looking out for you. Isn't that what siblings do? Just stop. What? Talk to me. It's not my fault. I didn't lock us in here. I didn't kill the cultists. I didn't even kill the warden. Which one? Neither. You did. And the demon. I'm all innocent. I've not harmed a single soul. Of course not. You make me do it for you. I didn't make you do shit, Andrew. You chopped the bastard up all by yourself. And you chose to do everything you've done here. And guess what, Andy? Don't. You chose to lock in that crate. Where the fucking cunt choked. Put yourself to sleep to that. Andy, my poor Andy. So, that just came out of your mouth. What, it's true. You chose to do it. And you chose me. You chose me. Me! You backpedaling fuck of a brother! You chose me, you did! Jesus Christ. Ugh. So I guess we're not leaving here together. You can't do it. You won't. You can't, because I'm the only one you can talk to. When you can't sleep at night, and you can't take it, I'm the only one who can make it go away. Fancy that, when you're the reason I can't sleep in the first place. I would like to go now. With Andy. I'm ready to go now. Go like, did? Of course not. I want to leave this apartment before we get caught. With you. Can we go? I'd like to go too. But the thing is, you're pissing me off so much right now. We go now, and you'll just throw another fit later. Yeah, I probably will. I'll make such a scene too. Yeah. So I don't know if I can risk it. Maybe I'll just end you here and be done with it. So if you can come up with a compelling reason not to, I won't. Well, I already said there are sleeping pills for that. Yeah, okay, I got nothing. But I'd like to go with you very much. Though if you plan on ditching me anyways, then fuck you. If it's not going to be just the two of us, then forget it. God, did he bruise her? I don't give a shit about. I'm glad she choked. I know you are. No one knows it was us, so what does it matter? And as long as it's just us, are you saying you'll behave? I'll behave if you behave. Isn't that how it goes? Who knows with you? Though I'm assuming we're getting out of here in the first place. That's right, our quest continues. What did we name this episode again? Andy and... Okay, but I'm not gonna be Andy anymore. Huh? He's so spineless. And I hate Leyley like you wouldn't believe. Huh? She better stay and die here with Andy. So you and I can leave. Fine. Whatever that means in practice. I like you, but you're so exhausting. Nonsense, I'm invigorating. Let's leave. I never revisit this conversation. Yes, I've got the keys to the second floor and also the warden's gun. I'm surprised you didn't shoot me yet. Maybe later. Let's get out of here, Andrew.
They have a very unhealthy relationship. Like, incredibly unhealthy. Dead of the stone. Go to second floor, I guess. Whatever is out of order. I want to read the note. And I guess they said fuck the note. Oh, whatever. They're clearly so. It's obvious they're harvesting. They're harvesting specific people. It seems like, at least.
Look, an open window. Great. Jump. Tempt me not, Andrew. I mean, it is the only the second floor.
really don't want to take your chances with that. Damn it. Isn't there like a rope or something we can use to climb down? Use this rug. Oh yeah, I was like, what the fuck was that? Then I remember. Fourth floor, maybe? Oh wait, I want to see if he adds any dialogue for this. Guess not. Are we not even going to mention the item we got from the freaking demon? No. Whatever. What do we even use? Clothes. Oh. No. That rope up there. If it is, I ain't reacting to it. What the fuck? Anything in here, maybe? Walking all over the person's dead fucking body. Go to the third floor. Is there anything in here we could use? Maybe? Nail gun. Alright, check. There's nothing there. Snooping around the lady's bathroom, were you? I had to wash her blood off me. Ew, right. Excuse accepted. Thanks. What do I do? What do I do? Don't have key for the first floor. Climb down the window using this carpet. No! Oh my god. I'm not sure how we're going to secure it though. You hold it while I descend. Oh yeah, and I'll just jump into your arms once you're down. Would that actually work? Maybe if you catch me instead? Hell no, I won't. We've got to set up something to hold the carpet in place while we climb down. Well, let's leave it by the window for now. Got carpet. Couch. Random couch. In the hallway. No. Girl. Oh my god. It's gonna crack the wall. The fuck? Need something to secure the carpet with. This couch is literally right. Here! What would I even secure it with? still think putting the couch on is far more secure than nails. Oh, it's so fucking smart. Two of you use a nail gun to nail the carpet onto the wall. Doesn't look safe. There has got to be something else. I'm going for it. If nothing else, maybe the carpet slows my descent down. I mean, I guess. Alright, you first then. Damn right I go first. I am a lady. You climb down very unladylike. Oh, well, it worked. We didn't die. So what happens now? Well, what happens now is that we'll skip town. And then find a buffet restaurant. Ooh. Oh yeah, we stole all that money from that guy. Then we'll steal someone's identity or something to continue our lives. Easy peasy, huh? And then, as long as we never come into contact with the law enforcement, we'll live a quiet life and die. You've got it all figured out. Good God, I have no idea what we're going to do, Ashley. First things first, skipping town and the buffet. Let's go to a real touristy location, maybe some traveler would drop their ID. Then we'll rent a place using that. I'm sure we'll find some grunt work somewhere, too. Even then, I don't think that's going to. Shut your mouth! It'll all work out. Lest we'll live under a bridge or something. Like trolls. We'll eat those who won't pay the toll to cross. How can you laugh? It's anything but funny. How can you do anything else but laugh? Everything has gone to crap. Keep it together. I am! Let's start by catching a bus. I'm happy. I'm happy to be up there, too. And otherwise, I'm a hair away from a panic attack, thanks for asking. I didn't get to tell you before, but friend I called while you were downstairs gave me a gift. Do I even want to know? Supposedly, I should be seeing visions of the future in my sleep now, but who knows? Well, I hope you do. It would be handy when it comes to avoiding certain things. Yep, so you can relax a bit. I'll keep my sleeping eyes open. But it also means you can't leave now. You're stuck with me. Nothing new under the sun. Stuck, huh? Are you? Oh yeah, completely stuck. Yeah. You get on a bus and drive the hell out of there. Vroom vroom, motherfucker. End of episode one. I don't even want to save or something? It carries over to the full game. Save game. See you in the full game. Oh, okay. I don't even have any idea. Like, I can't even guess. Begin to guess. How the next episode would follow. Like, I don't even know. I guess the next episode would be them just, like, on the run or whatever. Oh my god, they're both so fucked up. Holy shit. Ashley concerns me big time, like, with certain interactions with her brother. But I did like it, though. That was definitely different and really enjoyable. So, hey, there's that. I recommend playing it and when the full game comes out. I guess it's just a demo. I'm definitely going to get it. I didn't see where it goes. Like, I'm committed now. I have to see where it goes. So, until then.